हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम चेतन सिंह सोलंकी। आई एम हियर विथ माय एनर्जी स्वराज यात्रा एंड दिस यात्रा इज़ फॉर 11 इयर्स। इन 2020 आई हैव स्टार्टेड दिस यात्रा एंड दिस विल कंटिन्यू टिल 2030। तो आई एम अ प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम IIT बॉम्बे, बट व्हाट इज़ द रीज़न दैट आई स्टार्टेड यात्रा? वन ऑफ द मेन रीज़न इज़ दैट climate is not changing, climate has changed. You know, all of us can feel what is happening in the world. Weather system has changed, winter is not same anymore, summer is not same anymore. So the climate has changed and the question is, who has caused the change? So all of us, every human being on this planet, whether we belong to India, Africa, America, Europe, whether we are rich people or poor people, everyone is using energy. And because everyone is using energy, 80 to 85% energy comes from carbon source, petrol, diesel, coal, etc. And therefore, we are all responsible for emitting carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is a greenhouse gas and causing global warming. Right now, the planet is already warmer by 1.1 degree centigrade, which is equal to 2 degree Fahrenheit. When our body temperature increases by 2 degree Fahrenheit, we say body has got the fever. Similar to that, the planet has got the fever because the planet's temperature is increased by 2 degree Fahrenheit. Climate scientists tell us that we need to limit the global warming to 1.5 degree centigrade, and we do not have much time before we touch 1.5 degree centigrade. The time left today is only about 7 to 8 years or maybe 10 years. All over the world, government has been taking action. You know, there are COP meetings, every year COP meetings taking place. There was a Paris Agreement in 2015. There was a Kyoto Protocol in 25 years back. But all the government efforts at level, international level, national level, are not working out. And therefore, I realized that it is not enough for the government alone to take action. Each one of us are using energy, each one of us using resources, and therefore each one of us are contributing to the climate change. And therefore, who would be the solution provider? Each one of us. Every individual should become a solution provider by means of converting 100% into solar energy. So we need to switch 100% to solar energy. We are all living using solar energy. We exist because of solar energy. And that is what is Energy Swaraj is all about. So Energy Swaraj is all about becoming energy independent. I believe that when each one of us become energy independent, the government will also become energy independent, and we will be able to solve the problem of climate change, which is already becoming a very serious problem. So the Energy Swaraj should become a public movement. It should become a movement where every individual start taking part in contributing, and that is why I started this 11 years yatra. I decided that for 11 years I am not going to go home. I started this in 2020 from Bhopal, and till 2030 this yatra will continue, and I am hoping that I will reach out to millions and billions of people so that we all can start climate corrective action. And today is a beautiful day, today is Earth Day, and I am so happy to be here in this institute and able to talk to you. And I hope that with this, all of you together, with the institute together, with all the young students who are sitting together, we would be able to really create a public movement, and we become proud, you know, energy independent, and we will all adopt Energy Swaraj. If we do not do that, you know, it is estimated that by the end of century, the temperature will go to 3, 4, 5 degrees centigrade. And there is a big question mark whether human life can survive on this planet or not from 100 years, 150 years from now. And we say that, you know, once upon a time, there were dinosaurs on the planet. They are not there anymore because they disappeared because of the climate change. If we are not taking, we are not going to take a right action immediately, urgently, there will be a time 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 years later, then some new species will come on the planet and they will say, once upon a time, there were humans on the planet. I hope we will not get into this situation, and before it becomes too late, let us all start taking action, let us all become energy independent so that we can make this planet sustainable for ourselves and our future generation. Thank you very much. Get extinct, you know. The problem, we are getting into such big problem. It is not a question of cost anymore. It is a question of survivability of human life and how we are going to survive. But it is not expensive. There is a misconception, you know. The solar electricity, governments Indians are buying at 2.5 rupees, 3 rupees per unit. At home we pay about 5, 6, 7 rupees per unit. In industry we pay about 7, 8, 9 rupees per unit. So it is already very low cost. It is already very inefficient, very efficient, and therefore it is perfectly viable today. People have to just understand that by using coal, petrol, diesel, we are causing huge damage to the environment. And therefore we say prevention is always better than cure, right? So let us prevent the catastrophic climate change before it becomes too late. So adoption of solar energy has to go beyond cost reasoning, and we have to do it because we want our children to live happily and sustainably on this planet. The technology has evolved so much that government should be out of the whole solar business. We do not need government's intervention anymore because it is already low cost. And because subsidies are there, but it's a very small quantity. Government cannot give money to everyone. And the best thing every state government and central government can do today is stop subsidizing solar energy. Let it become a public, let it become a market-driven product, like we buy our refrigerator, like we buy our cars. Solar energy should also be market-driven. And I believe and I request with all of you, through you, all the state government to stop subsidy so that the solar energy promotion can really spread much faster. With this my yatra, I have already kilometers about traveled about 20,000 kilometers. I have met about 1 lakh people, and I am expecting that by 2030 I am going to travel about 2 lakh kilometers of the journey.
How is your yatra experience, sir?
My yatra experience is really wonderful. Because of the corona, people understand that there is a problem. Because of the change in weather, people understand that there is a problem. So people are understanding that the climate change is a problem, and everybody can feel it. You know, people do not need scientists and engineers to tell that there is a problem. So people can feel that, but people do not know how to behave, how to solve the problem. Whether to use solar energy, not to use, whether to use subsidy, not to use. So one good thing is people do understand that there is a problem, and therefore my experience is good. I am feeling positive, I am feeling energetic, and that's why I am sitting here. Today is my 512th day of my yatra. So since last 512 days, I am living in a bus, I am sleeping in a bus, and I am still very energetic and not tired, right? So there is a very good response, and I believe that when yatra will be finished in 2030, we will have millions and millions of people living 100% on solar energy, Atmanirbhar, independent, without any connection to the grid. I hope people will start taking pride in saying that I am not part of the pollution, I am part of the solution. I am running my life 100% solar energy. That is all energy, Swaraj.
What is the inspiration?
Well, I mean, I keep saying that when there is a tiger behind you, you don't need motivation to run, right? When the climate change is such a big problem, you do not need any other motivation. The problem is really big. As I said, it is a question of survivability of human life, and therefore there is no other motivation. Let us all work together, act together. Let us all realize that each one of us are cause of the problem, and let us all become the part of the solution. That is my motivation. Yes, but the whole purpose of my yatra is that I believe that government alone cannot solve the problem. I also believe that the corporates cannot solve the problem. Then who will solve the problem? Each individual and institution, particularly the academic institution, because this is where we are nurturing the life of our future generation. So if academic institution becomes part of this Energy Swaraj movement, I think that we are really great. So I really have a lot of hope from all the young students who are sitting there, that together, because it is their future which is going to be affected more, with them we will be able to create Energy Swaraj as a public movement. So the role of academic institution